behalf of Nazarbayev University leadership, faculty, staff, and the Board of Trustees, we would like to welcome you to the 2019 graduation ceremony of Nazarbayev University's Graduate School of Public Policy. Today's celebration will take place as follows. Part one will start with a processional made up of our graduates, faculty, NU, and school leadership. Next, Nazarbayev University President Shigeo Katsu and our guest of honor, Mr. Asiat Isakyashev, will each address our graduating class. Our graduates will then receive their degrees from the university and school leadership. Following the awarding of degrees, we will hear from our student speakers. At the end of the ceremony, we will be honored by a video of the first president of Kazakhstan as he delivers his congratulations to the graduating class. Thank you for your attendance at today's event, and we sincerely appreciate your cooperation. In preparation for the ceremony, please silence all the mobile phones. And now, please. Welcome Master in Public Administration students of Nazarbayev University Graduate School of Public Policy. Welcome Master in Public Policy students of Nazarbayev University Graduate School of Public Policy. Welcome the faculty of Nazarbayev University Graduate School of Public Policy. Welcome the platform party of Nazarbayev University led by Nazarbayev University President Shigeo Katsu. Please rise for the national anthem of the Republic of Kazakhstan. I'd like to now give the floor to the president of Nazarbayev University, Mr. Shigeo Katsu, to address the graduating class.
Dear graduates, I'm sure you've already listened to this, but first of all, let me address our distinguished guests. Asa kadal atanarlar. Kambatti Tiliktirmen Ponaktar. In particular, the director, executive director of the First President Fund, Steve Kishas. Kurmetti Nazarbayev Universitetinin Kamdastiri. Sizlerge bugungi tarihi yeste kalatin kunde bizben birge bolgandaranis ishin algisimde bildiremin. I first of all, really foremost, would like to address my thanks to the parents, the family members. All of you have supported the students that are now proudly graduating today. So thank you for your support. Thank you for, it's not always easy times when you have cranky students or nervous students who are gearing up for their homework and their exams. You know, you all have to had to bear with them. So thank you very much. To our graduating students from our Graduate School of Public Policy, whether you are from the full-time MPP program or the MPA program, you are going to enter, as I also said yesterday in my speech already, a world, a VUCA world. You often have heard me say this, I repeat it again, a world that is ever more volatile, ever more unpredictable, ever more complex, and ever more ambiguous. And some of the ambiguity we already see here throughout, even in our university, where indeed we are struggling through simple questions as to how do we try to manage our digital future. No? And it rings home very closely to me because Provost Adesida and I have been trying to put our signs on your diplomas. It's only that we have 900, almost 1,000 diplomas to sign, you know, and sometimes we think maybe a robot might help. No? But of course, a robot doesn't have any judgments at this point. So, we have to, you know, it's just a small example of how we are actually all affected by digital changes. And some call it disruption, some may call it just evolution. The fact is, as I said yesterday, everybody has to be prepared because by 2030, as we heard, you know, McKinsey and company and others predict that probably about 15%, almost 15% of the global workforce has to learn new skills. And that's enormous. Now, I do hope that the skills that Dean Venkat and his team and faculty and staff have tried to convey to you and inculcate you to you, make you ready, future ready, to take on whatever challenges are being thrown at you. Public policy itself is rapidly evolving. And as we see, some of the ambiguities start to bleed through, the differences between public sector, private sector, some of the, you know, in the English language, or in particular in the US side, you often call it even a revolving door of relations or appointments between public and private sector. What's important is that you are able to always think in terms of being able to contribute to the policy discussions, to design policies in the public interest, and not be necessarily captured by certain interest groups. And that's a very, very tough thing to do. The Graduate School of Education Dean, Aida Sagintaeva, when I listened a little bit to her speech, she made a point of talking about choices. Everybody has to make choices. You make the choice of either a career in the public sector, or maybe in the private sector, maybe in academia, or maybe a hybrid career choice. You are going to choose, and I'm sure that you're going to choose wisely, and you're going to choose with a long-term perspective in mind. And long-term perspective means please do continue learning. Please do continue to ask questions. That really is at the heart of being able to continue to learn for the rest of your life. Our doors are there, open. You are part of us. You're part of Nazarbayev University. And hopefully we will always be part of you as well. And do come back. We will try to make things in the future. Lifelong learning is just a key word, interesting for you, always welcoming you. But there's also one more thing that I hope you are all taken away, and that is our core DNA. You heard me talk about it a little bit yesterday, but it's the DNA of Nazarbayev University in terms of integrity. You heard a lot about it, academic integrity until now, but of course it is built on personal integrity, very strong moral compass, always be compassionate and consider others that are less fortunate. At the same time, dream big, as we talked also yesterday. And this moral foundation, it's not something that we were able to instill in you, but it comes from your parents and your family. So once again, thank you very much, your family members. Thank you. I salute you. And one thing that also came through before I conclude, at the recent Astana Economic Forum, there was one session, interestingly enough, on how do you motivate civil servants and public sector people. Of course, pay is important, but actually it's also motivating, what sort of gives intrinsic motivation to public sector officials when pay differentials are there with the private sector and so on. Intrinsically, it is trying to contribute and do well and make a difference in society. I'm sure you're going to make your mark, and I'm sure that you're going to be the difference maker for Kazakhstan in the future. So thank you and congratulations again.
Thank you, President Shigeo Katsu, Mr. Aset Isikesha, our guest of honor. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure as the Dean of the Graduate School of Public Policy not only to congratulate you on your graduation, but also to later to introduce the guest of honor for this graduation ceremony. Now, as Mrs. President Shigeo has said, that most of you and your families have made sacrifices to go through this rigorous education journey in our school in the past 1.5 to 2 years. It is a journey that I know all of you will remember because of the challenges that you've gone through, and I also know that you will also cherish it after you leave us. For some of you, you may continue with us, but the majority of you will leave us, but I think you will remember with very fond memories the time that you spent here. I hope all of you will stay true to the important reason and motivation that have brought you to the Graduate School of Public Policy and also brought you through the MPP and MPA program. Now, of course, the important reason which many of you have stated in your interviews is that you are committed to public service. Yes, that's very true. And you also want to improve the well-being of the people of Kazakhstan and also your country that you come from. And I know that you are, and you will stay true to those commitments. So when you think of GSPP, I hope that you'll be reminded of what GSPP stands for. Not only the Graduate School of Public Policy, but G meaning that you want to be a good citizen, right? G. And who is committed to G, good governance, because you know that that is the surest way in which the well-being of the citizens will continue to improve. S means that you want to maintain a strong vision. Strong vision based on very sound values and sound principles, so that you will be able to utilize, secure in utilizing the skills that you have acquired. D during the time that you spend in your MPA or MPP program to enable you to make the right decisions so that you can provide effective S and R solutions to the problems and challenges and difficulties that you face. P means forward. P is to always maintain a proper perspective of the problems that you encounter. To perceive the underlying public good. Now, all of you have know what public good is, right? Something that you will never forget. What is public good? You know, you don't look at the individual, but you look at the value to society as a whole. And so that you will know what is crucial, the public good is crucial for the resolution of problems. And finally, a P. P means that you will pursue with determination what you are convicted are the right paths and the right measures to follow through. Now, I hope that you will not only pursue, but you will also prefer to do what is right with a huge dose of humility and integrity. So this is what I hope you remember, not just the Graduate School of Public Policy, but with what GSPP stands for. Now, it is my pleasure now to introduce to you our guest of honor, Mr. Asiet Isikashev. Mr. Isikashev is no stranger to many of you. In fact, he's so popular that he was the one that all of you wanted to be the guest of honor for today. And we are so thankful that he has kindly agreed to come despite his busy schedule. After graduating with a degree majoring in law from Al-Farabi Kazakh State National University in 1994, Mr. Isikashev went on to do a master's degree in public management, right? Or public administration, which is, of course, you have done. And after his graduation with a master's in public management degree, he went on a very successful career in public service. Some of the highlights of his career. In 2003 to 2006, he was a Vice Minister for Trade and Industry, or Industry and Trade. 2006 to 2008, he was the Vice Chairman of the Board for Khazna Fund for Sustainable Development. 2008 to 2009, he was the aide to the President, or now the first President of Kazakhstan. From 2010 to 2014, he was the Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Industry and New Technologies. From 2014 to 2016, he was the Minister of Investment and Development. From 2016 to 2018, I'm sure many of you know, he is the very popular Akim of Nur-Sultan City, right? On Astana. From 2018, September to March 2019 this year, he was the head of the Presidential Administration. Of Kazakhstan, and from March 2019 onwards, he went on to become the executive director of the Foundation of First President Al-Basri. Now, of course, he is the role model I think that every one of you would want to emulate, right? And this shows that what you can do with a public policy, a public administration training, you can follow the footpath of Mr. Asiet Isikashev. So it is my pleasure now to welcome our guest of honor, Mr. Asiet Isikashev, the Executive Director of the Foundation of First President of Republic of Kazakhstan, to deliver his speech to us.
Хайырлы күн, құрметті ханымдар мен мырзалар, қадірлі ұстаздар, құрметті түлектер. Бүгін сіздер үшін ерекше күн. Осы жерде тұрған 49 түлек магистр атанып өмірінің жаңа кезеңіне аяқ басқалы тұр. Баршаңызды шын жүректен құттықтаймын. Алған білімнің жемісін көруге тілектеспін. Әрдайым жолдарыңыз ашық болсын. Дорогие выпускники, для вас такой волнующий момент, такая сложная пора закончилась, когда одновременно вы учитесь, работаете, воспитываете детей по выходным, праздникам, поэтому я вас поздравляю. Это непростое время, и вы молодцы, что взялись и за эту учебу, я думаю, это очень актуально не только для вас и для нашей страны. На самом деле вы закончили этот прекрасный университет в очень интересное и важное время для нашей страны, вы все прекрасно знаете. И сейчас в Казахстане проводится курс на модернизацию, реформы во всех сферах, в экономике, в социальной сфере, в регионах, в системе госуправления. И все они направлены прежде всего на реализацию главной миссии государства, это значительное улучшение жизни и уровня казахстанцев. Это вопросы повышения реальных доходов населения, улучшения качества жизни во всем, что окружает казахстанцев, образование, здравоохранение, экология, общественный транспорт, безопасность и многие другие. Задачи непростые, вы все их хорошо знаете, наверное, где-то работали. И с учетом тех вызовов, которые сейчас есть и глобально, и в регионе, и внутри страны, для успешной реализации этих непростых задач необходимо, в первую очередь, эффективный и качественный государственный аппарат и новое поколение государственных управленцев. Об этом говорил Елбасы Нурсултан Абишевич Назарбаев в прошлогоднем послании народу Казахстана. И поручил, во-первых, и государству подготовить соответствующие реформу в системе госслужбы, и Назарбаев университету Академии госуправления обеспечить подготовку таких специалистов. И вот в этот момент как раз вы выпускаетесь. Действительно, конечно, государство нуждается в грамотных управленцах. Из своего опыта тоже знаю, что сейчас найти очень хороших управленцев очень сложно. Это должны быть люди, обладающие навыками системного мышления, стратегического планирования, проектного менеджмента, открыто умеющие разговаривать с населением. Самое главное – быть эффективными. Это самое главное – эффективными и ориентированный результат. Поэтому я думаю, что в этом прекрасном университете вы получили прекрасные знания, опыт и практику, которую вы примените в жизни. Хочу сказать, что, конечно, все равно теория немножко отличается от практики, поэтому надо быть готовым именно свои навыки мышления применять. Не всегда знания помогают. И во-вторых, в нынешнее время знания устаревают очень быстро. Нужно постоянно учиться, постоянно читать, практически ежедневно быть в курсе всех вещей, иначе отстать быстро очень, очень можно очень быстро от всех других стран. Хочу пожелать вам достичь, во-первых, успеха на государственном поприще, успехов в вашей карьере, в вашей работе, всех целей, которые вы поставили перед собой. Ну и, конечно, семейного благополучия, крепкого здоровья. Желаю вам успехов. Еще раз поздравляю. Ну и в завершение я еще раз хочу поблагодарить руководство Назарбаев университета и школу госуправления, всех преподавателей за прекрасную работу. Dear Mr. Katsu, Mr. Heng Teng, Mr. Teachers, thank you for all what you are doing for our country, that you invest into upbringing an amazing new generation of Kazakhstani people. It is a great job, I think. Thank you very much. I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Isakesha, for your encouraging words. I would like to now invite Nazarbayev University Provost, Dr. Adesida, the Dean of Graduate School of Public Policy, Dr. Hui Wengtat, and our guest of honor, Mr. Asiat Isakesha, for handing over the diplomas. Will the recipients of Master in Public Administration degree please come forward to receive your diplomas?
Калиева Айнура. Мирзаев Максат. Холдасов Айдос. Мухамедиева Алия. Темирханова Назира. Кенжибек Айдарбек. Дашенов Нурлан. Шарипов Тенрух. Канатбаев Раван. Жекей Бахыт. Айжанов Айдос. Жумажанов Арман. Рената. Гангожин Ильяс. Имашев Ануар.
Will the recipients of Master in Public Policy degree please come forward to receive your diplomas?
Diploma with honors. Хасетов Нурбек. Тайбасарова Арайлым. Бекова Мадина. Хотым Лазиза. Бургегулова Асель. Арагул Бекнур. Даутова Наргиз. Сыздыкова Жансая. Диас Асим. Уразалина Маржан. Ахметбек Айжан. Сейтек Шолпан. Үсен Ажар. Караев Олжас. Хорманов Вибрат. Асабаев Алпамыс.
Congratulations to the class of 2019. It is now time for us to hear from some of our top students on their experience here at Nazarbayev University and their thoughts and dreams for their future and the future of Kazakhstan. Our first student speaker is Janar Ismailova, who is graduating with a Master in Public Administration. Janar is from Almaty region, and she started her career as a teacher of English. However, her career path evolved from the educational sector to the consulting area in public and government relations. Janar entered GSPP's master program in 2017 to complement the practical knowledge she has gained during her work in a public policy reform project. After graduation, she has joined GSPP as a manager for executive education programs.
Құрметті ата-аналар, профессорлер, бітіруші түлектер, достар. Көзімізді ашып жұмғанша бүгінгі қуанышты сәтте келіп жетті. Назарбаев университетінің жоғары мемлекеттік саясат мектебінің түлегі атанып отырмыз. Бұл жетістік келешекте алар белестердің бірі ғана деп сенемін. Ұшса сұңқардың қанатын талдыратын, шапса тұлпардың тұяғын тоздыратын, кең байтақ даламыздың, егемен еліміздің бетке ұстар азаматы болуға бар күшімізді салатымызға сенемін. Ертеңгі өзгеріс бүгіннен басталады. Алдағы бастамаларымыз тек сәтті болғай. Dear GSPP community, graduating students, family members, and other guests, it's a great honor today to represent MPA class of 2019 at this ceremony. Dear classmates, thank you for giving me this opportunity to express our sincere respect and gratitude to our professors, and other GSPP team members who has made our journey in GSPP as smooth and enjoyable as possible. And indeed, all of us agree that this past 18 months of MPA program has passed as 18 days. And I would like to compliment GSPP admission committee who had such a good judgment in selecting such extraordinary and enthusiastic students. Every week we were longing to see each other, to get knowledge from our professors, and also we learned a lot from each other. In addition, of course, Singapore component memories will be with us forever. My next words of gratitude go to our families. Without the support of our families, we would not be able to succeed in this journey. This is especially true for me because I have entered this program as a mom of 2 months old child. So, at one of our very first lectures, one of our most beloved professors, Omer Barış, told us that when we graduate, we should forget everything that we were told during the lectures. Instead, the strength of the school is reflected on the level of soft skills we show after the graduation. And in this regard, I can definitely say that studies at GSPP developed our social and emotional intelligence, our sense of social responsibility and time management skills. And the latter is especially important because we had to combine our work, family, and school schedules. Every effort to meet school deadlines made us more resilient. In addition to that, it may sound like motherhood and apple pie. We learned about the importance of giving back to our community, and public administration is a favorite area for these purposes. So, thank you, GSPP, for this opportunity. Thank you, classmates, for this wonderful experience. I wish you all the best in your future and careers. Let GSPP be our meeting point where we can have chai s molokom with no control and punishment.
Thank you, Janar. Our next student speaker is Nurbek Yesitov, who is graduating with a Master in Public Policy. Nurbek is from Atarau. He completed his bachelor's degree in Earth Sciences in 2012 at the University of Minnesota on a Balashuk scholarship. Following graduation, he began working in Schlumberger as a field engineer to later join a technical college in Atarau as an instructor. Later, he served as a deputy director for academic affairs and implemented several projects to improve college experience for local students. Nurbek aspires to contribute to public service in his hometown, Atarau.
Thank you. Dear distinguished guests, GSPP faculty, parents, and graduating class of 2019, I'm so honored to be standing here today and representing to the MPP cohort. My fellow graduating classmates, congratulations to all of us for successfully defending our projects, finishing all finals and memos, and making to the finish line. The long-awaited moment is upon us. We've been awarded our diplomas, and now it's time to start collecting kurumdiks. Now might be a great time to visit our nagashlar and their nagashlar, because they're usually generous for kurumdiks. 2 years ago, when introducing myself to GSPP faculty and other students, I said, I drove 2,000 kilometers from Atrau to Astana, so I hope my time here would worth it. Well, it certainly did. I had two exciting, challenging, and great years here at GSPP. And for that, I'm truly grateful to GSPP for providing me with opportunities to participate in student conference in South Korea, to visit Singapore for a semester, and most importantly, big rahmet to our professors for sharing your insights and guiding us through policy alternatives, stakeholder analysis, and memo writings. My personal thanks to Professor Peter Howie. You, sir, rock. Before coming to GSPP, I thought having a geology background and petroleum industry experience would not be useful sets of skills for public policy. Well, you proved me wrong. I think geologists can make a great public policymakers. And now, to my fellow graduating friends, I think it's an exciting time to be graduating. As we are witnessing historical changes on the political landscape, Kazakhstani society is picking up its pace to become a further driver of the changes. So as we enter the labor market as public policymakers, I think we can and should be the facilitators of good governance by incorporating core values that we learned here, the integrity, meritocracy, and accountability, by applying good practices that we've learned as students at GSPP into new sets of policies that would make our country a truly democratic, open, tolerant, and better place for all, regardless of our origin, ethnicity, gender, or who we belong to, or where our parents work, or whom we love. Let's make that happen. Ақжол баршамызға, еліміздің жарқын болашағы біздің қолымызда. Thank you.
Thank you, Nurbek. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the video of congratulatory speech from the first president of the Republic of Kazakhstan delivered yesterday on May 31st.
Уважаемые выпускники, наступает торжественный момент. Я от души поздравляю вас с успешным окончанием университета и в добрый путь, друзья!